إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اعلموا عباد الله أن أحسن الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد عباد الله my dear brothers and sisters what was the quality, the basic quality that the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam he had that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him al-Khalil? If there was one single quality you can think of that would make someone like Prophet Ibrahim Khalilullah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him in the Quran, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا, that Allah has made Ibrahim his Khalil. And the meaning of Khalil means the most beloved, the ally, the best friend in that sense. In the Arabic language, Al-Khulla is basically when the love for someone penetrates the heart and is absorbed by the heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a manner that suits His Majesty, made Ibrahim most beloved to Him. But why? He has a quality that is supposed to be the title by which we identify ourselves with. It is the quality that would make us truly those who are Muslims to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is becoming very problematic in time like ours. That quality is submission. Submission to the Lord. Submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah azza wa jal talked to us about the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, He says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ. Those who yarghabu an millati Ibrahim, which means they turn away from the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Those who turn their back to the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam, illa man safiha nafsa, they fool themselves. They fool themselves. They tricked themselves, which means they lost. And what was the quote of Ibrahim? إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When Allah said to Ibrahim, submit yourself. Submit yourself. Ibrahim didn't even ask the question, for what? How much? How long? How? He didn't ask me the question. He said, my Lord, I submit. I submit myself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is for that reason that Allah azza wa jal made him Khalilur Rahman. Today, we have a crisis in our communities. As Muslims, every now and then you watch the news and there's a news story about some Muslims who identify to become an ex-Muslim. And this is now becoming a very, very common phenomenon, unfortunately, that they are among the youth and as well today. You have people who are in their 15, 16, and 17. They go to Islamic school sometimes, but they still have a faith crisis. They have a problem in their hearts and their minds. Parents are freaking out right now. Every now and then I get a request from parents to counsel their child. So what's going on? It says, well, they have so many questions about faith. That sense of submission is kind of going into erosion in our hearts, in our minds. What made Ibrahim so unique to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that fashion is making us right now going far away from what we're supposed to be. Those who submit themselves to the will of Allah azza wa jal. You know, that feeling is not just with youth and young ones. It's even with adults. Adults who've been Muslims for so long and now they're having this faith crisis. They go into their 20s and 30s and 40s and 50s of almost every age. Even lately, I had a conversation with an elder who is actually close to 70s, and they have a faith crisis. Subhanallah. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect us, Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin, min al-hawri ba'd. To turn back our back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after Allah had guided us, Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin. That's a very serious issue today. And we're going through it, and we're just kind of like, always making dua, Ya Allah protect us, but are we taking the right steps to understand what the crisis is? You see, when it comes to submission to the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was the way of Ibrahim and his household. And I want to talk to you, inshallah, in this khutbah about the meaning of submitting yourself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how could you truly be that Muslim, that you have that peace of mind and tranquility, and not to worry about any distractions in this world. So let's talk about Ibrahim alayhi salam and his household and his family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us that Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was again the number one person who submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfectly. In the way that he let go of all the control and he gave it to Allah azza wa jal. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. Allah told Ibrahim, submit yourself. Ibrahim didn't ask a question. He said, I do. I submit myself. And then he would ask the question, how do I do it, Ya Rabbil Alameen? But I just need to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That sense of knowing that your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator and you are the creation, it what makes that difference. It what makes you humble yourself and submit yourself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he put all the control in the hand of Allah Azza wa Jal. Everything in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The story when his people, they were worshiping the stars and the moon and the planets, and then Ibrahim alayhi salam, he had this debate with them about who is my Lord? Ra'a kawkaban, he saw a kawkab, it means a shining star in the horizon and in the sky, and he goes, this is my Lord. And then it just disappeared. He says, that's not gonna be a Lord. How could this be possible if it just disappears? And then he saw the moon, it was bigger. Says, this is my Lord. And it disappeared. And then he saw the sun, the same thing. And Allah documented that in Surah Al-An'am. He says, فَلَمَّ رَأَ الشَّمْسِ. When he saw the sun, he said, قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّ هَذَا أَكْبَرِ. This is my Lord, this is the biggest one. And then when it just disappeared, he told his people, said, no. None of these things is my Lord. That I will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'll submit myself to Allah azza wa jalla hanifan. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. I will stay on that straight line to Allah Azza wa Jal, and I don't want associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِي لِلَّهِ. I am turning my face to Allah Azza wa Jal. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِي لِلَّهِ حَنِيفًا. I'm just turning my face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again on that straight path. Which is why when we start our salah sometimes, what do we say? Dua al-istiftah, the opening statement. وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِ الَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. That I turn my face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth, and I would never worship anyone with Allah azza wa jal. These are the words of Ibrahim alayhi salam in that moment. He's showing his submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once you submit, what's going to happen next? Then you're going to need to be tested to prove it. A lot of people, they think, you know, just because I'm a Muslim, I should have an easy life. Who said that, Jama'ah? You see, the Quran is an open book exam. There are no secrets there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you say I believe, I'll test you. Alif lam mim. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَيُتْرَكُوا أَيَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do you think we're going to be let you say I believe and then you're not going to be tested? And Allah says, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. We have tested those who were before you. What reason? لَعَلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا. Allah should know those who are truthful for those who are not. So once you submit, then now you need to prove it. A man once came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, "Qala ya Rasulullah, qul li fil Islam qawlan la as'alu anhu ahadan ba'dak." Tell me something about Islam. I don't have to go ask anyone after you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave him a very simple answer, but it's so powerful. He said, "Qul amantu billah thumma istaqim." Say, "I believe in Allah," and then prove it. Just prove it. But how do I prove that? That's when you submit to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal says, قَالَ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا. Who is best in their speech, in their statements, when they talk? Who is better than someone who, مَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْمٍ مَنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. That they call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means they have faith in Allah azza wa jal. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. And then they proved it through their good deeds. وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And then they say, I am among those who truly submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of us as Muslims, we do believe in Allah azza wa jal. Alhamdulillah. We have that faith in our heart. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen that faith, ya Rabbil Alameen. But then comes now to prove it. And that's when people now, they're very diverse. How much we put effort into proving it, that's different. Depending on the strength of our iman. Some of us, mashallah, very dedicated, devoted. Devoted all the time to come to the masjid as much as they can, to give in charity, to smile in the face of other people, being nice and kind to others, forgive them when they make mistakes on their way. And other people just like say, you know what, as long as I do my five daily prayers and Jum'ah and say La ilaha illallah, I'm good. So people, they have different ways of proving it. And then Allah says, وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ And they say, I am among those who submit truly to Allah Azza wa Jal. That's when the test comes in. It's not just about saying it or doing it. It's about when you're tested. How are you going to react to these tests? Ibrahim alayhi salam was one of those people. He was the one who submitted himself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala no matter what. He was tested so many, many times. So many times. And one of those tests, when he was brought into in front of the public to testify, if he was the one who destroyed these false idols in the temple. He said, I didn't do that. Look at this big one. He has the axe on his shoulder. But then they all knew that he is the one who did it. And they wanted to punish him. How did they want to punish him? They wanted to burn him. They wanted to prove it to the people that, you know what, no one messes up with our gods, these false gods. So they built a huge fire and they called upon the public to come and witness the execution of Ibrahim alayhi salam. In the seer, it was mentioned that this fire was lit for days and nights, constantly, you know, fueling it, continuing to flowing it. Why? Because they wanted to prove to the people that no one messes up with their gods. Eventually, when Ibrahim alayhi salam was brought right now to be thrown into the fire, it was so huge and massive. They were unable to throw him into the fire. They had to catapult him, throw him into the fire. In the seer, that when he was actually in the air, he was tied with his arms and his legs. When he was in the air flying towards the fire, it was be few seconds from just being into the fire. Jibreel alayhi salam comes to him. And Jibreel tells him, قَالَ هَلَّكَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ حَاجَةٍ Do you need any help? Can you imagine? Put yourself in this position, Jama'ah. You know, this dire situation, a moment, I mean seconds and split seconds from subhanAllah, from a fatal situation, so destructive situation. And now Jibreel comes to you and says, wish for something. Your wish is granted. What do you wish for? What did Ibrahim alayhi salam tell him? If I were there, I would actually grab to Jibreel alayhi salam, help me out. Instead, Ibrahim alayhi salam tells Jibreel, قَالَ أَمَّا إِلَيْكَ فَلَا حَاجَةٌ From you, I need nothing. وَلَكِنْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ But Allah is my hasib, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for me, and my full reliance is on Him. Like from you, thank you, JazakAllah, I appreciate that. But I don't need you, I need Allah Azza wa Jal. And instantly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed the laws of physics. The fire that's supposed to burn, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell that fire? قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the fire to be peaceful and to be cool for Ibrahim alayhi salam. Changed it. When Ibrahim alayhi salam came out of the fire afterwards, even though it was shocking for these people, but their arrogance made them refuse to believe. And that's why he left. He went to the Sham alayhi salatu wassalam. And there Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with an opportunity, become the Khairul Rahman. He was tested so many, many, many times. One of these tests, he was going old without having children, even though he was married. And then, subhanAllah, he got his wife Hajar. And that's when he had his first child. After all these years, you've been blessed with a child. A great ni'mah. Guess what was the gift that was given to Ibrahim alayhi salam in that moment? After waiting all these years to have a child, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell Ibrahim alayhi salam? You go, send your child and your wife to Mecca, which is basically at the time it was just nothing but a valley, a dead valley in the desert. And now can you imagine, after waiting for all these years for your child, and then all what you get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now that you have a child, send him away in the desert. Now, subhanAllah, thinking about it logically, just like, how could this be possible? This is just that my wife and a little baby, how are they going to survive there? I mean, he could argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring his case, and his case is legit. Right? But his belief in Allah and his trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surpasses all these way of thinking. He said, absolutely. And he takes his wife and his baby child Ismail into the middle of the desert, a place that was dead completely, was absolutely nothing there. And as he was leaving, he made that dua. قَالَ رَبِّ Said, my Lord, إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ My Lord, I'm leaving some of my offspring and my family there بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ, in a valley that is dead and has absolutely no trees and no vegetation. عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ, but the unique thing about it is near your sacred home. Your sacred house, the sacred house which was not built at the time yet. It says, رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. What was his concern? His first concern, he said, رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ, so that they perform their ibadah and they pray to you. That was his first concern. Ya Rab, guide their hearts. فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِرَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِ إِلَيْهِمْ. My Lord, make a group of people of good heart to come and incline towards them. Let them come and see, stay with them. And then he said, وَرْزُقْهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ. My Lord, provide them with food and fruit. Subhanallah. The ulama of tafsir, they say, why would Ibrahim alayhi salam, in a situation like this, delay the request for the basic human need? He made it the third thing to ask for. I mean, if you're leaving someone in the desert, what do you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ya Rabb, take care of them. Ya Allah, feed them, bring them water. That's the first thing you say. But instead, Ibrahim said, Ya Rabb, guide their hearts. Ya Rabb, bring them good community. And then Ya Rabb, provide them food. Why so? The ulama, they say, because Ibrahim alayhi salam, trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was unparalleled. And he knew this is given. Allah will take care of that part. He doesn't have to ask Allah for it. Because Allah promised that He will take care of us with food and nutrition until our time comes to an end. And then that's it. So Ibrahim wasn't worried about that. He was worried about their guidance. Today in our life, in our culture, what do? When people move into any community, what is the first thing they look for? School districts. And they want to find the right school district for themselves. They look now for the real estate market. Where's the best place to live in? And once they have the house, and then they say, and then they look for the masjid, and it's about 25 minutes away. And then just like, subhanAllah, the masjid is too far. Ya, you chose to live far from the masjid. You see, Ibrahim alayhi salam was thinking differently. No, I need them to be guided first. I need good community around them. And then, Ya Allah, provide food for them. That is trust in Allah. That's full submission. And then when Ibrahim was leaving, his wife calling upon him, Ya Ibrahim, where are you leaving us? Where are you leaving us? And then she said to him, is this is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you? Is this is the command of Allah azza wa jal? He said, Allahumma na'am, this is indeed from Allah azza wa jal. And that's what then she said to him, said, if this is the case, then go ahead, go for it. Go, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of us. Look at this now, submission that is coming also from the mouth and the heart of his wife. A lot of men, a lot of ladies, they hope that their spouses have this submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to that level, that they have trust in Allah, so you don't have to worry about anything. You know, that brings you peace and tranquility. Wallahi, if you just let go and put that trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His judgment, no matter what happens to us, it's part of the test. I need to be patient with it and submit myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will find that peace and tranquility. Hajar, she realizes it's coming from Allah and she knew that Allah will take care of them. However, that doesn't mean just sit down there and do nothing. You need to earn it. When we say to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's judgment, doesn't mean you don't do anything. No, you take the right actions. And then let the results in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when her baby starts crying, what did she do? She was looking for food. She was looking for water. She was going from one mountain to the other one just to see if there's any caravan passing by. And then seven times going back and forth, trying everything possible, making every possible effort to survive on her child in that desert. And then Allah teaches us a lesson, teaches us all a lesson through this story. The water start gushing from underneath the feet of the baby himself. Like Allah is telling us, listen, you could do whatever you want. At the end of the day, the results are in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mean, the expectation here is that, you know, if you run from back and forth on these mountains, somehow you'll find a caravan, you'll find some safety or some shelter. But Allah is telling us that you do your part and I'll deliver. But Allah's deliver on His terms, not our terms, as part of the test. And what's required from us to find peace and tranquility is to accept and submit after doing everything in our power to get the right results. But then at the end of the day, it's in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Submission in the household of Ibrahim, it transferred to his children. Ismail alayhi salam, when he became a young man and he started helping his dad building the Kaaba, and Allah reported that in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَدِيَرْفُ عِبْرَهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Ya Allah, as they were raising the foundation of the Kaaba, And they were making dua, Allah accept from us. And Ismail would say, Ameen, Ameen. Ibrahim making the dua, and Ismail would say, Ameen. In every brick they say that they were building, he would say, Ya Rab, accept from us. And Ismail would say, Ameen. Every brick he puts there on the Kaaba, Ya Allah, accept from us. And Ismail would say, Ameen. Like they're putting every effort for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they put their trust in Allah azza wa jal. They build the Kaaba. And then now it's time to celebrate. What was the celebration that was given to Ibrahim alayhi salam? Allah tells him to sacrifice his own child, the only child he had. He had been waiting for this child for so long, and he was away from him for so long. And now, subhanAllah, he is in that moment. He's in that moment that Allah is telling him, okay, now sacrifice your child. We're done. Wouldn't it be possible for anyone to accept this command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at some moment? We're human beings after all. You see what is so unique and beautiful? The fact that Ibrahim alayhi salam was away from his wife and his child all these years, what is so unique and beautiful is that his wife, the mother of Ismail, she raised her child to love his father and respect his father. That's difficult, Jama'ah. So difficult. Like, I'm not getting anything in return. But because we trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah's judgment, then we're just gonna like, I'll accept that. So Ismail, Ibrahim goes to his son Ismail, and he's telling him, قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. My son, I've been seeing in my dream that I'm sacrificing you, so what do you say? Now obviously in a moment like this, Ismail could return to his father, says like, are you okay? But what did he say to him? They knew, nothing is random. These things come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he said to his father, قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. If that is a command from Allah, do it. Just do it. سَتَجِدِنُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. I'll be patient. Like, I'll submit myself to Allah. And then Allah documented that incident. And he says, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَ. When they both submitted themselves to Allah Azza wa Jal. وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. And he held him from his forehead, getting him ready for the sacrifice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends now the end of this test for Ibrahim, saying, قَالَ قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. That's it, you're done. No more tests for you. You proved it. That was the ultimate test probably you could think of. The sacrifices, and Allah said to Ibrahim, that's enough. That's it, you pass. Now, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us not to go through any test to that level, Ya Rabbil Alameen. But you know what? Life guarantees all the opportunities, but doesn't guarantee any results. And it's my duty and your duty to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and regardless how much effort I put in there, Allah is not guaranteeing any result for you and I. He's guaranteeing the opportunities for us. You see, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he made dua while he building the Kaaba for us. What was his dua? When he was building the Kaaba with his son Ismail, he would say, رَبَّنَا وَاجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. He would say, رَبَّنَا, our Lord, اجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ. Make us both among those who truly submit to your will. وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا, that's us, and among our offspring, our children who will come after us, an ummah, a nation, people who will submit themselves to Allah Azza wa Jal. That's the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Which is why today, what are we called, a jama'ah? Muslims. And where is it coming from? It's coming from Islam. And what is Islam? It's the true meaning of submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now remember though, we can claim it. We can say that I believe, alhamdulillah. But what did Allah say afterwards? وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا. Who is the most perfect in their statements than those who say, I believe, and do good deeds, and then they submit themselves to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might believe. I don't know about your practice though, but for sure, if you want to see if you're doing the right thing or not, test your submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the one that will guarantee you peace and tranquility in this life and in the hereafter. May Allah give us submission to Him, Ya Rabbil Alameen, in the way that is pleasing to Him, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, When it comes to the submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no doubt it is the trait that made Ibrahim alayhi salam Khalil Rahman and will make everyone to become most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, how do I submit to myself to the will of Allah Azza wa Jal? It's very crucial and very important to understand that submission. A lot of it has to do with the submission of the heart, not the submission of the hands or the eyes or the feet. Submission of the heart. If you can get your heart to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from inside, everything else will follow. Everything else will follow. So sometimes you just come and say, I've been praying for the past, many years, but I don't feel it. Well, check your heart. Where's your heart when you're praying? Is it in submission? Yes, I can see your body submitting because you're coming here for Salatul Jum'ah, but is your heart with you? Or did you leave it somewhere else? That's the meaning of submission. If I can get my heart to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether I'm praying, fasting, with my spouse, with my children, in my life, if I can submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the inside, I guarantee you submission will be easy from the outside. And that's what we need to work on, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Now, one last thing I want to share with you here is that when it comes to what cut ties between us and our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, what cut ties between us and our loved ones in our life, our spouse, our children, our parents, what is it that thing that kills all the relationships? It's called the silent killer of all relationships. We're going to talk about this tonight, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, here in this masjid, bi'nillahi azza wa jal. The silent killer of all relationships, what is causing problems between you and your children, between you and your parents, between you and your spouse? And you know what? What is causing people to lose connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It is the exact same thing. And it has to do with what we've been talking about here in this khutbah. I ask all to come and join us, inshallah ta'ala, tonight, bi'nillah azza wa jal, to learn more about this. Save ourselves. Save our families. Our relationship, inshallah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allahumma allimna ma yanfa'na. Wa anfa'na bima allamtana. Innaka anta al-alim al-hakim. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. Wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. Anta waliyuha mawlaha. Ibadallah, inna Allah malaikata yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Warda Allahumma an khulafa'ir rashidin Abi Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali wa an sa'ir as-sahabati ajma'in wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin. Wa aqim as-salah.